a young metro, I don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot. Get it from morning, get it some.
So I just got done editing tomorrow's video, trying to be consistent. I'm super tired because I had work earlier. I'm gonna go read a couple of slides for lecture, and let me just show you guys a sneak peek of what this video. We'll show you the end. Yeah, so I'm exhausted. I'm gonna go read these notes and head to bed. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I think I have legs with Jared tomorrow morning. Jared and Justin. Yeah. Me and Jared has legs with me. So, I'm gonna go get some rest for that. Finish up these notes. Go to bed. See you guys in the leg video. Never really realized how difficult it is to do things with one hand. Oh, for today, Roshi's, Gymshark, legs. Do I even live here? Hit my stupid self in the car.
Oh my god.
So raw. Where's Justin? Where is he? Is he at the gym? This nigga at the gym. There is always a ridiculous amount of traffic coming into this gym. For no reason. Come on, I just wanna go do some legs. Hopefully I get this park right here.
Panda. I got broads in Atlanta, just at the lean the family. Credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the banner. Legacies, family. Wayne see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, family. Wayne see, panda. Pocket smoke, Danny. Selling ball, candy. Then on the macho like Randy. The chopper go out to for granted. Nigga, bullet, you bandit. Hope you killers understand me. I got broads in Atlanta. Twisted the lean in the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the looks in the banner. Legacy, family. Way is he, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the hammers. Legacy, family. Way is he, panic. Package roll, Danny. Sell it, ball, candy. Man out the macho like Randy. The chopper go out for granted. Then he could pull up your banner. Hope you killers understand me.
Hey!
Panda. 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 Panda, 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 panda. I got broads in Atlanta, chasing the meanest shit, sipping fountain. Credit cards in the scammers, wake up beside your shit, let it sound.
Okay, so I posted on Facebook if anybody had any fitness related questions for me to answer in my next video. So, I got a couple questions and I just took this opportunity to answer them, right? So what is a good pre-workout meal? That is a very subjective question because it deals on what particular muscle group or what particular type of exercise you're going to be doing when you come into the gym. So for example, a typical leg day like we saw before, we just did legs. In order to drive me through that workout, I would have had high amounts of carbohydrates in my breakfast. Right? A normal day I would have just had moderate carbs or little carbs. Right? It's all according to what you are planning on doing while you come here. Right? So you can't just ask that question unless you really know or state what you plan on doing. So leg day I just advise high carbs just to drive you through it. Right? On another day just any kind of substance in your stomach, right, would drive you through that workout, whatever it is, whether it's chest, back, shoulders or whatever. Right? But I advise, since the legs is one of the harder body parts to work, takes more out of you, you do need more carbohydrates, right? So Aaron asked, what is the best time to take a mass gainer in the day, aka carnivore mass? He says 2 scoops in the morning, 2 scoops after workout, with 4 scoops being a serving. So the way a mass gainer works just like any other protein, except it has way more calories than a lean protein, right? So essentially what you should do, because a mass gainer, as you all probably know, has higher amounts of protein in it, usually around 60 grams of protein per serving and around 1,000 plus calories according to the brand, right? It is often better, there's 2 ways you can do it. I advise post-workout, right? Make immediately after your workout, you can have it pre-mixed at the gym, leave it at the gym behind the counter or the fridge or whatever, right? And take that protein, that mass gainer after your workout, because that's when your body needs those macronutrients the most, right? So if 4 scoops being 1 serving, right? And you know they always say your body can't absorb anything over, I think it's 40 grams of protein, right? Per sitting or per meal. I don't know how true that is, but just going with that rumor. You shouldn't be over consuming protein in one sitting. So you should stick to doing what you're doing. Have your 2 scoops in the morning when you wake up and your 2 scoops after you wake up, because you want to be spacing out your protein consumption throughout the day as well. Because remember, while counting the macros, you need to fit that budget of protein for the day. So if your protein is, let's say, 180 for the day, and you do your 4 scoops immediately, that's literally just a whole 60 grams going right there that you could have spaced out during the day, right? And 2 people asked a question, macro counting, and do a detailed breakdown on dieting and macros and how manipulating your macros will help you achieve your goals and how it breaks down into actual foods and portion sizes. That's from Carlos. Alright, so many people are against if it fits your macros, right? I've always liked the idea, but it's warning. It's a very hard thing to do if you're not focused, right? So counting your macros involves weighing your foods and knowing your portion sizes, right? So if it fits your macros is a diet or a lifestyle where you decide, okay, you have a macronutrient limit and a caloric limit for the day. That's a fact, right? So whatever your caloric limit is for that particular day, for example, say you have 2500 calories for the day, right? Let's use these as examples. So you have 2500 calories for the day, right? And in that 2500 calories, your macronutrients are broken down into 3 types of food groups, right? So you have your proteins, your fats, and your carbohydrates. Those 3 things are very essential, right? So you need to keep counting these things. So whatever you put into your body must be recorded, right? And what this allows you to do is keep an active record of how much food you are actually ingesting, rather than a typical bro diet where you just put servings on your plate, right? And you really don't know how many calories or how many carbs, fats, and protein you are intaking. If it fits your macros, allows you to actively count and keep track of how much you are eating to prevent 1 overeating and undereating. Going back to that 2500 calories, right? Just an example, right? In that 2500 calories, say you have 275 grams of carbohydrates, 210 grams of protein, and say 68 grams of fat. Just those 3 numbers. I
I forgot those numbers already, but just go back in the video and you know what I'm talking about. So you have those three numbers that I just mentioned, right? So in those three numbers, right, in breakfast, what do? You have your kitchen scale. Your kitchen scale is a very accurate measure of the food that you will be eating, right? So for example, in your breakfast, you have your oatmeal and you have your eggs, right? So obviously everybody knows one egg is 5 grams of fat and 6 grams of protein, right? So if you're doing it like that and you're weighing out your food, right, and you want to eat oatmeal and eggs for breakfast, what do? You weigh out your food, because normally when you're doing weight training, you don't usually eat full eggs. If you really know what you're doing, you usually mix either one whole egg and a couple egg whites, and you have your oatmeal on the side, whether it's Quaker or prepackaged oatmeal or whatever the case might be, right? So what you want to do, if you do buy the prepackaged oatmeal, they're already weighed. They're already, the macronutrients are already set for you, so you just pour them back and just look behind the label and read out the facts. Or if you do buy the loose oatmeal, right, and you throw it in a bowl and you don't know how to measure it, right, then you never know how many calories or proteins, fats and carbs you're really intaking, right? So what do? You have your food scale. This is your food scale here, right? You put your bowl on top of your food scale, then you zero your food scale. So right now you're literally weighing nothing. So whatever you put in the bowl is all that's being weighed. So say you weigh out 56 grams of oats. That's one serving, usually one serving, right? Which is, I think, like 120 calories, 7 grams of protein, and like 1.5 fat or 2 fat, right? Something like that, right? So just use that as an example, so you know exactly you have 56 grams of oats equals that macronutrients. So going back again, that's how you know exactly how you're eating, just using these as examples. These may not be very accurate numbers because I'm speaking on top of my head right now. Because usually when I'm doing this, I have my fitness pal opened up and I know exactly what numbers create what for food groups, right? So just giving you the idea. The benefit of counting your macros is at the end of the day, when you have a full meal and you do weigh out your food and you weigh out your meat, your for a protein source, you're weighing out your beans, your rice, your sweet potato, or whatever form of carbohydrate you choose, you exactly know what is coming into your body, right? Too many people are dieting, and really don't know what they're putting into their system. I mean, don't get me wrong, some people know what works for them, right? But I rather be accurate, right? Simply, if it fits your macros, allows you to be accurate with whatever you put into your body, right? When you're in a caloric deficit, it helps you lose weight consistently and steadily, right? Because as you continuously drop your calories and drop your carbs, drop your fats, right, you know that you will lose weight at a steady pace rather than just cooking and eating clean. Eventually you will lose weight, but it won't be as steady, it won't be as accurate, right? It's a more scientific method of doing your diet, right? And when you come to your macros, it really does help you get leaner, right? And you really know what results you're supposed to be getting. So if you're not getting those results, you high chance you're doing something wrong. So with that, I think that was a bit of a rant. This might be a longer video, but thanks to my boy Justin for filming. Justin did all the cinematics for himself, picked up the camera, and he did everything. All I did was edit the video. So with that, thanks for the support. Follow me on Instagram, @BTimers. Follow me on Snapchat, @BTimers. And Justin, what's your Instagram?
Justin_98.
Justin_98. That's JUSTYN_98. We up.
This camera thing, Leon, are you not
on that?
Come
on, Aaron! Oh, welcome to my cookie. For supplements, check Body Glow Trinidad. Upstairs, Mario Celerado.